There we go, shove that in there. Oh yeah, that could be a problem. Oh yeah, that's got a few issues. No problems. Could be a problem.
This video is brought to you in part by TrueTech Tools. Quality tools, essential support.
Alright guys, so we're out here to do a no heat call, and up there is two package units, state-of-the-art LuxAire garbage. I can smell from here. What's wrong with it? They say you can't smell carbon monoxide, but whatever happens when they totally go all to hell like they're doing right now, it's going to be completely plugged up. You can see black around the exhaust pipes there, which are kind of engineered looking. These are likely running on propane because we're out here in the middle of nowhere. So let's see what we can get. Well, at least we got a skid loader bucket there to fall on if we fall off this ladder. So there's an igniter. Woo, doggy, good Lord, it's enough to gag a maggot. Whoo, yeah, we're out here in the middle of nowhere. They build barns and stuff. Yeah, I can't imagine why it would act up. And this one here's got the same crap, so I mean, it wasn't built for that. It may be screwing up and reducing the flow of exhaust. Yeah, ain't gonna lose no screws up here, huh? Yep. So that's fastened on there. Yeah, there goes the screw. I don't even know why they did that. There's really no reason to do it. Other than the fact you got downdraft. Yeah, didn't even put a curvature in there or nothing. Oh, that's nice. Yeah. So the heat exchanger's completely sooted up. I don't know what they want to do with this now. You can try blowing it out, try washing it out. None of the above is going to work all that great. About burns your eyes. Okay, just shut the fuel off to it. I'm gonna let this thing cool down. My feeling is, if you had bought a carrier, it would have been set up with pressure switches that would shut down if the propane gas was too low. Very likely what could have happened is this ran low on pressure and it sooted up because of that. Yeah, it's the same thing, I'll soot it up. I mean, they obviously have had enough problems with it because they only got one screw in each one of these doors. Oh, somebody's already yanked the heat exchanger the cover off this for a reason of one sort or another. There's where it is. You can see the one comes up and shoots the heat, just boom, out there. And same thing here with this. It comes out and just, I think they may have installed all this themselves. There ain't a whole lot to know about on that other than, yeah, there's probably not the greatest airflow in the world. All right, so it's only 31 up here. It's not that cold, but by God, that freaking wind, you can see it wiggling. That's making it feel a lot colder. One heat exchanger was just replaced, I found out, and it was this one he thought he replaced. This one here, he thought he just had to convert it. Some yin-yang from some other installed these and didn't even convert them to propane. So our guy had to convert it to propane. This one might just be an issue with pilot, but I'm trying to figure out how in the world this thing goes together, whatever. He said not all this comes with the heat exchanger. And honestly, this is piss poor engineering. Literally, this is making this wind come down and hit me like twice as hard as what it really is. And that's probably why they put these crappy extension pieces on there. This is how I judge equipment, based on whether or not it's got a good design to work on. Turn the gas off, see if we can get, yeah, this is great. Appears to me those two bolts there might hold this piece of fish on here. All right, just got this for Christmas. These are flip bits, bigger, quarter and half inch there. Half inch one there, it's probably the only one we need. So grab this little extension here. That should allow us to get that out. Look at that nice deep well socket. Ain't that badass? Okay, do a little conversion there. Yep, got it. Beautiful. Got it. Beautiful. Look at that. That's a little easier. See how that works. Just, it's got a pilot tube there, shoots it across the front, arcs right to it. Burners look good. I don't see anything wrong with those. They're in good shape. Let's take a look down here in this mess. It's not horrible. Not like it's brown all the way through. It's actually fairly clean. Now that one there is bad. Oh boy. That one there is really bad. And this one here is really bad. And this one here is not horrible. So 3 out of 2 out of 5 are good. I mean, we could kick it on, let the draft motor purge it out, blast it through with a nitrogen hose into there, and it's gonna blow black crap everywhere. Might be able to be enough to get them going. I mean, it's gonna break some of it loose, but man, oh man, oh man, that's a long ways to blow it out. That is a long ways. I mean, that's forward, back, you get those screws there. Let's go ahead and turn this other one back on, see what flame patterns we got going on with it. So what I end up doing on that there is kind of backing this up a bit and then gave me room to thread it on and then just kind of see if I'm tighten that bad boy up. Jumping back over to this one here, it's running. So I mean, if the flames ain't rolling back, looks like they're about all the same. If you kind of even get some down pressure there, that's not causing any disturbance. There it does, if you completely block it out. I don't know, that's gonna turn into a total wreck. And now that I know that one of the heat exchangers already been replaced, what do you do? What do you do? It's running, leave it run. Anything but thought out. There we go. So, umpteen million screws, and it looks like you can get in there and you can maybe see the top. If the top's not sooted as bad, we might be able to do something with this. It's kind of loopy-dooped in there somehow. Such a well-thought-out design by LuxAire. No wonder why they're such a shish company. It's both the Goodmans of the group. Oh, looky there. It looks like they put screws all along the side of it. Oh man, what kind of idiots. And then they got this plate here blocking that. So it's just like these here on the side. I think they got it going into the same piece here. No thought process at all. Well, bud, I'm thinking maybe we're just best off to blast with nitrogen, hope for the best, and go from there. I don't know what else to do with it. It's just gonna blow it up to the top and it probably ain't gonna get it all out. It's not like I've had to do this with this model before. It's like, this is why you stick with a company that you freaking, if you're gonna skimp out, just consider it a throwaway equipment. So now, you know, if it was ours, I know the tricks I can get away with. Heat exchanger on a carrier, which ain't the greatest, change in a couple hours. All right, so this is the propane tank over here. It's about the size of a rail car. It's thing I seen on this here I didn't like is I think they're going from liquid to vaporizer. And you can see it. Now, if that's the case, I would understand why this is doing what it's doing. Level's 50%, but here's what I assume is maybe the vaporizer. This is possibly liquid, and this is changing over to vapor, because see how it's ice? What that can cause is possibly an issue with the gas pressure dropping if the diaphragms are taking a dive. Now, according to that, we've got a 10 PSI coming out of it. That's technically what you would want. Usually that's what goes to your second regulator. Okay, let's go ahead and check this gas pressure. I want to know what our incoming gas pressure is. This crap's going to keep happening, and I really don't want to deal with it more than once. I really would like to see them just replace it. Let's go ahead and get this in here and see what we got for manifold pressure going in. Should be at least about 11 and a half, 12. I usually like the top end of it. 11.3. So 11.35. That's under load. It's a little on the lower side, not crazy, but it's a little bit. Yeah, these are factory default. They don't even have paint scratched off yet where the adjuster is. There it is, 13 and a half maximum. Minimum, that would be an LP thing. So let's get it up to 12. Worst case scenario, let's get it up to 12. That way we got room for adjustment. There's 12. So now we can put this back in, because sometimes that'll change it too. Now we gotta check manifold. So, yeah, either way, I think we're gonna have to just tell them they need a new heat exchanger. What I wanted to do is make sure that we're not gonna have it again, but it seems like it's been happening over and over, as far as I know. See how they didn't think that out? Sometimes you can use the pilot tube to get it to turn into it. I think what I'm gonna blast some nitrogen through this thing, see if I can just get it running. I think this is gonna be an ongoing problem over and over. Running 7.9, 9.5, 9.5 inches. I don't know if that's normal or not. All right, we're gonna pull the nitrogen bottle up here. I'm gonna try to blast this thing out. Oh, let's get this thing to turn on. Go ahead and blast some in through the burner area here. There we go, shove that in there. Oh yeah, that could be a problem. Could be a problem. I used to do this on old furnaces. We'll do this on this one here and see what happens. If it runs clean, great. Don't have to tear all the heat exchanger apart. There we go. No problems here. Nope. Okay, now that that's running, this stuff's really fluffy. So, I mean, in reality, it should come right out. Let's go ahead and... There we go, we got blown diesel. There we go. Okay, got that one. See if we can get some of these other ones. Here's one. Oh yeah, that's got a few issues. No problems. Right on my new jacket, loving it. I'm loving it. Here's the other one. Oh yeah. Yeah, that one's all jacked up too. Fantastic. Problem is I'm about running out of pressure. I got another tank, but dang it. Yeah, something else. All right, so they got some air hoses. I'm gonna try to use some of this first, then maybe nail it, the rest of it with nitrogen. Look at that, freaking soot everywhere. Crazy, jeez. Okay, let's go ahead and just yank these loose. You'd be surprised how clean this will get. Yep, that one's pretty bad. Probably can't see it, but it's pretty bad there. So is that one. That one there got most of the crap out of it, sorta. I don't know, man. It's just a fucking mess. Oh my, yeah. Go. Oh yeah, look at that. That's all good stuff. Here we go, you ready? Oh yeah. That's nice. Oh, the motor's locked up too. Oh, it gets better and better. Yeah, look at that. So it's got a bad motor. Got a bad blower motor. Oh, man, that is great. Yep. So we got a bad blower motor on this one. Yep, see? Broke some crap loose. So what we need to do is put a piece of tape on the spray nozzle, stick it in there and impound on it. Or a wire tie might work too. Oh, there goes that blower motor again, it's shot. So what's the point of even working on it, I guess? It's got, I probably got a centrifugal switch in there. Go ahead and wire tie it like that. Stick that in there like that. There we go. That's blowing through there. And then let's pound on this thing. See if we can get some stuff to come out of it. Yeah, look at that. See that? Oh God, right in my face. Fantastic. Lower motor must be able to take off that time. It's got problems. Yeah, it's great. More money they can sink into it. For most part, we got a good majority of it out of there. There's a little bit of looseness there that we might be able to get with a brush. Okay, I'm using my tire changing tool here to see if I make me a boiler brush. I haven't needed a boiler brush since being at this company because we're a refrigeration company that does heat and air and stuff like that, and it's just not that often that I need it. This will make it run. It's just, is it going to happen again? Probably so. I guess we told him he needed to put a low pressure switch on it and he didn't want to buy it. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Let's turn this back on. There we go. See if it'll come on 90 seconds here. Let's go ahead and get this other one back together. I think I'm gonna build me a sheet metal piece that goes on the end of that and just bring it out like a normal extension that Carrier would use, because what they've got now, I don't feel is working right. I think could possibly be causing our problems. It's hard to say without seeing it, you know, long-term, not knowing the history. There it goes. Go 9.5 area, give or take it 5/10. Yeah, it's got some white smoke to it there. Don't smell like it did earlier, by golly. Burners are shooting right in nice and strong right now, but like I said, there's some residual in there, and soot don't usually burn off. I mean, it's soot is the leftover byproduct, so I mean, that was always the story everybody always said, well, it'll burn off. Yeah. Soot sticks is what they were back in the day. All right, this one's working. It has no smell coming out. I'm almost curious to check it with the analyzer just to see. I don't know what kind of effect the old leftovers would have on it. It's hard to say. I'm not real sure. Got to get the numbers off this motor. I don't like having to order it from the factory if we don't need to, however. This is going to be a long video. I'm going to do a lot of cutting to make it short. It's at 13.3 when it's off. We didn't look at this earlier, but let's go ahead and look, see what kind of blinks we got here. 6 blinks, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. High temperature switch open. So we tripped that enough times that it caused an issue. Oh, here we go, right here on this front. See that? What happened was, yep, heard a click. So the fan didn't kick on one of the times, and that's what shut it down. So in theory, if I was like, some people, you just come in here and hit that button and leave. That would have caused a problem. So, yeah. Let's go ahead and let it start over now and see what we get. Union's tight. Still waiting for it to try here. Okay, it is lighting the pilot. I can see the pilot there on the right of that, but it's not getting all the way across, I don't think. So there's an issue with that. Okay, so it could be something in one of these little prongs here. So we're gonna go ahead and get them scratched out as best we can, because something probably floated down in there, a little speck of soot or something. See if we can get this back in there again. All right, this high piece of quality machinery here is still not lighting. So we're gonna yank the pilot tubing out. We're gonna see if we're getting it out of the gas valve. Very strong. Maybe something got in the orifice. I was able to do it like that and I could hear the gas come out pretty fast. So we are getting fuel to the pilot tube. Let's see what happens now. You gotta be really careful doing that, especially with LP, because otherwise it could blow up in your face type deal if something would cause it to ignite. Not probably the safest thing in the world, but sometimes practical thought is what it takes. Well, it must have been a little scared because it came on as soon as I walked away from it. So we're at 12 inches right now. And if we're shooting for 9.5 or whatever, this one's been running steady, no problem. Yeah, that blower's got some problems. All right, so lucky me, I have a Testo and I have a Inficon combustion analyzer. We're gonna check that over and see whether or not she's running dirty. Sampling the outside air. I'm gonna check this other one, see how it's burning once it's calibrated. And then that'll put to rest all the complaining I'm sure I'm hearing in the video. Oh my gosh, I can't believe he's doing that. That's so stupid. What do you do when they just changed a heat exchanger 2 months, 3 months ago, or this summer? And then now it's sooted up again. What do you do? There's only so much you can do, man. I don't know how easy it is to get this junk. Do you want to change this crap out here in the weather? It's only going to get colder. We're only in January. Oh, it's 35 degrees outside. Auto zero. There we go. Keep it. All right. We are at O2, 20%. CO, zero. See what we get here. Now, this does have a protect feature that'll shut it down if it gets too high. We're gonna just put it down there for a second, pull it away, and see if it starts jumping up high in CO. It didn't. There's CO coming up. 200, 300, 400, yeah. I set it for 500. It's still running dirty. Yeah, unfortunately. Tell you what, we wanna get this out of there. That was stupid. I should have just pulled that hose out and blew it out. Obviously not truly made by Inficon. Whoever makes it, which it's made over in Italy, is making it for Yellow Jack and a few others. I mean, this thing is only like $1,000, $1,200. It's pretty cheap. Plus it includes a printer. Whether or not that'll clean up itself, I doubt it. I really doubt it. You know, they should run for a while, as long as it don't run sooty again. I mean, you got soot there, which is, you know, obviously it's dragging across that carbon that's inside the heat exchanger. It's under 100 so far. O2 is running 6%. CO2 9%, 83% efficient. So far, pretty accurate. So, kind of curious. Do we not get enough air in those burners? I don't really like the way they're cut back so far. It should have been set up with an analyzer in the beginning, but these didn't even get set up correctly. I guess when they were started up, they didn't have propane kits on them. So we converted it to propane for them after the fact. Yeah, it's still up in the 90s or whatever. But yeah, that's the Inficon FluMate. TrueTech Tools does have this. You guys can pick that up
save 8% on it, most likely. I'm pretty sure everything so far I've seen my discounts worked on. There's some few things I think it don't, but survival for your code, just like all my goodies I've got here, the Testo stuff, the bag, all this stuff is from TrueTech Tools. So you guys want to support the channel and show them there's a reason that that they should continue to support me. They need to know that people are watching my stuff, and that's how they know when they start using my discount code. We got the gas pressure set 9.5 inches. That's done. So I need to put that all back together. I'm gonna wrap this thing up. I gotta go talk to the owner of this place and tell him what a mess he's got. He bought these at an auction, I guess, and then had somebody install it or something like that. That's what the Amish welder told me. And I'm serious, Amish welder. I think that's gonna wrap this up, guys. It's a long video. I'm gonna have to chop and chop and chop and chop. I mean, this has gotta be a lot. We're gonna chop, 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 chop. But what we did is we made a run, and it's running safely. We don't have any rollout or anything like that. We made sure our gas pressures are right. It's burning clean down below. You're picking up crap in the heat exchanger. I banged on them, knocked stuff loose while he was blowing it out. I mean, it's just about as good as you can get it. I tried to take this apart, which would have made me a lot happier. I could have then maybe run the brush through all different directions. The guy that changed the heat exchanger said there wasn't a whole lot at the top, supposedly, when he had it before. So, you know, I don't know if that was, you know, these were that way or not. But I tried prying it apart, and there's screws all on the sides. It's just a downright disaster. Other than that, I got to order a new motor for this thing, and that's not worth showing. I was going to build a hood for that, but I don't think I'm going to. I've seen plenty of them just go down at a slight angle. So let's go ahead and get this thing put together. Appreciate you guys watching it. Until next time, later. Yeah.